We know that light exposure in the evening suppresses the production of melatonin, which is a hormone that the body creates in order to prepare the body for sleep. We previously demonstrated that exposure to a very bright light in the hour before bedtime leads to a high level of melatonin suppression in young children. And young children are more sensitive to light than adults are because they have both larger pupils and clearer lenses in their eye, allowing more light to get in and impact the circadian system. So then we turned each child's home into a dim light environment for 2 days. We wanted to measure children's natural melatonin levels without any outside influence. On the first evening, we took saliva samples from the children throughout the evening in order to get a baseline measure of their melatonin levels. And then on the second evening, children were exposed to a light for 1 hour before their usual bedtime, and they received one light ranging from a very dim light to a very bright light. Finally, we compared their melatonin levels during the light exposure to those that we collected at the same time on the light before to see the impact of the light on their melatonin. We observed very high levels of melatonin suppression across all the light intensities, and we observed very high melatonin suppression even in response to very dim light levels, which is not what has been previously reported in adults. We saw that children had very low melatonin, even 50 minutes after the light had been turned off. Our findings suggest that light in the evening might be contributing to behavioral sleep problems in young children. And this is particularly concerning because recent reports estimate that about half of young children are using screens in the hour before bedtime. So our findings really highlight the importance of limiting light exposure in the home before bedtime in order to support healthy sleep.